My name is Werner Miller. I'm responsible for the security department within GEW, as well as a spectrum monitoring and spectrum management department. I think what's happening in South Africa and what's happening within Africa is a unique thing to our country and our continent. And being in a South African-based company, we're part of the people that can solve the solution.
With such a big amount of rhino that we have here, it's a gold mine for poachers to approach and to try to get their horns.
But there's no one that can single-handedly stop poaching and stop wildlife trafficking. And we're collaborating with all the people in the market to make sure we put out there a solution that can help them.
I have long ago developed a passion for breeding rhino, long before I even had to protect them. My motto nowadays is to breed better and protect better. And that is where we've got to with GEW.
I think in this industry, it's sometimes very difficult. The people don't have the technical skills and technical knowledge on the ground. There's also a lot of aggressive salespeople that like to push whatever they've got available. For us, it is not putting down the equipment and getting the business. For us, it's rather a journey to make sure that we supply the right equipment to them. And I think partnering with the right suppliers, installing the right equipment, we were able to put down very advanced technology here.
Nature conservation, as we see it, needs a soft approach as well as a hard approach. And we see the soft approach with regard to monitoring through cameras, also the movement of animals through radar technology, as very, very important. We're then able to look after the wildlife without intruding too much on the wildlife. We're looking to increase the range and also the capacity of our cameras. We're looking at increasing what we're doing with our radar operations, as well as being able to classify what we are looking at on the ground, whether that be, for example, animals, or whether that be personnel or vehicles.
We are, for the first time in years, feeling confident with GEW of perfecting the protection of our rhino.
We have a combination here of ground-based radar, thermal cameras, thermal perimeters, license plate recognition. We are also now starting to test gunshot detection, integrated with some advanced analytics, control room software, and all of that pushed onto a quite relatively easy user interface allowed us to get the operators up to speed on BDR relatively quickly.
Firstly, we are more relaxed in the sense that we've got more control over our detection system. We know that if something does try to breach the boundary, that we will detect it. We have thoroughly tested the system ourselves before we were able to sit back and say we are comfortable that the technology is actually assisting us. It took us 2 or 3 months to build up the trust, and also for the rangers to build up trust in the technology. And we're at a stage now where we fully rely on the technology as another tool in the toolbox.
The guys came in with zero knowledge of radars, thermals, this type of technology, and they quickly grew to become quite advanced operators. The idea is not to get them with inside of BDR. The idea is to detect them far out beyond the perimeters. Once they're inside, it's too late. The technology definitely allows for it to detect them a couple of kilometers outside of BDR. So they will have a hard time, not only with the technology, but with the whole security solution implemented here.
We need to prove to them and the poachers that if you come on here, you are going to be the loser.
Perception some days is that technology should be a silver bullet solution. You should put down one camera and it should solve all your problems, where technology is actually only a tool in the toolbox. And it should assist the guys to do their job easier. And thus it is the focus should be on adding technology, incorporating it into your concept of operation, and make sure it supports your concept of operation.
The boss that I'm working for, the owner of the property, John Hume, his objective is a zero loss. I'm the commanding officer at this project for John Hume, and my responsibility is to look after them and make sure that the poachers don't get to these animals. The rhinos are all in camps, a bit different than a normal wilderness area like in Kruger or the Sabi Sands, in the sense that once the poachers get to the fence line in a wilderness area, they still have to hunt for the rhino and find them. where in our situation, once they get to the fence, they can choose anything between 100 to 120 rhino to shoot. It makes our job difficult and also requires certain advanced technologies to assist us in the fight. And due to that, we've chosen two different types of technology. We want to detect the poachers far outside our boundaries, not at the fence.
Security has been difficult for us. We brought in basically what amounts to an army.
So we've reduced our manpower immensely with two-thirds of what we had before technology.
Those foot soldiers brought in poachers. So then we started aiming less onto foot soldiers and people and more onto technology.
We've increased technology right around our boundary, so we don't rely on a human being that can sleep, get drunk, be corrupted to do our detection.
Our last poaching was two rhinos poached 20 months ago. Before that, we had poaching every month, sometimes every week.
And funny enough, the last incursion that we had and that we lost a rhino was by a field ranger, one of our own members, and they let the poachers in while being on duty and then shot two rhino in the same instance. When you have the technology implemented, you actually take that section or that part of the detection out of the ranger's hands. I spent just over 2 years looking all over South Africa and the rest of the globe for the right type of technology and the right sensors to deploy in this environment. I drew up certain requirements. I spoke to GW and explained my requests and my requirements, and then they put together a solution that married my requirements. And from there on, the rhinos are safe.
My life's ambition was to breed 200 rhino per year. By the end of February this year, we would have bred 200 rhino per year for the first time. My budget for deaths is 80, so I would have a net gain of 120 rhinos per year. That is probably already the best in the world, including our national parks. The size of my project in hectares is 8,000, just over 8,000 hectares. I have 1,627 rhinos today. Part of the reason for that is to protect your rhinos. It depends on the size of your ground. I am now coming to the end of my life savings, and nobody is rushing to assist me and help me and tell me they will be the rhino's heroes alongside me. So I am very, very fearful that we will never see a revival of the rhinos. We had lost over 30 rhinos on this project to poaching. We are now in partnership with GEW, hopefully going to put an end to that poaching permanently. And that will be my focus into the future. Is finding enough money to go on protecting our rhino. We have looked into many and tested many, many technology systems to protect our rhinos. And as a compliment to GEW, it is the first one that has proved itself to be capable of protecting our rhinos.
At the end of the day, we together with them protect the wildlife, protect the rhinos.